What's going on, Bigger Pockets? It's Matt Faircloth. So today we're going to talk about LoopNet, right? And a lot of people talk about LoopNet. A lot of people think that LoopNet's like obviously a waste of time, not a place to go to find deals. I'm going to talk today about what LoopNet is, how it works, and how you can leverage it efficiently. Because I have bought deals off of LoopNet, and I want you guys to use it efficiently for your business. And there's ways to use it and ways not to use it. So let's dig in, right? So LoopNet is simply a listing service, and it lists pretty much commercial deals. It is viewed by most people on Bigger Pockets and in a lot of real estate circles as a place to find apartment buildings, but that's not all that's on LoopNet. LoopNet, you can find hotels and land and commercial strip centers, you can find medical office buildings, you can find resort properties, all kinds of stuff on LoopNet. It's just a listing service for commercial real estate. So it's just a commercial listing, right? Okay, but it's not really a listing service. They're not a broker. All they are is a place for people that, for brokers, for agents, or people that are selling stuff for sale by owner, whatever it is, to make people aware of a property they have up for sale. It's not a brokerage house. LoopNet is not representing them as an agent. They're not representing them as a buyer's rep, a seller's rep, or anything like that. All it is a commercial listing service. Okay, and as I said, there's all kinds of stuff on there. Now, a lot of people use LoopNet for apartment buildings, for finding deals and for listing deals. That's what a lot of the conversation that people bring up LoopNet is on. But I want to make clear, that's not all LoopNet is for. It's not an apartment building listing site. It is a commercial property listing site. So if you're surfing LoopNet for deals, maybe take your blinders off a little bit and try looking for other stuff on LoopNet. Because yes, apartment buildings are competitive, and they're really competitive on LoopNet, and that's not LoopNet's fault. That's the market, okay? So look at stuff that's not as competitive, and you might find a little better cap rate, a little better deal, maybe get educated on a different asset class of real estate, and you might find better deals on LoopNet in general than just saying, oh, LoopNet doesn't have good deals. So first of all, try other asset classes, okay? Okay, because I've seen mobile home park stuff on LoopNet, I've seen self-storage stuff on LoopNet, it's all out there. Okay, that's number one. So let's talk about it's a place for brokers and people selling stuff for sale by owner on LoopNet. So people say LoopNet doesn't have good deals. Let's talk about why that is, okay? So first of all, why bad deals? Why no deals? Okay. Well, I wish you guys were here talking to me because I'd love to hear what you guys say about why LoopNet doesn't have good deals. But here's my opinion. Again, I'm not the CEO of LoopNet, but this is my opinion of why LoopNet has bad deals, okay? Or does not have all kinds of deals. Number one, right? Okay, and forgive me, commercial brokers that are watching this right now, because I'm not trying to call y'all cheap, but LoopNet does cost money. Okay, there is a fee to list properties on LoopNet. This is not a hobby for them. They do make money doing what they do, and the way that they make money is charging people for listing stuff on their site. It's not a percentage of the sell price. It's not a commission. It is a listing fee, and the listing fee goes up the longer you want to leave it there. It goes up if you want to have it towards the top of the fold, more and more people notice it. If you want to upload all kinds of different stuff to it, if you want to put more photos or whatever, there's a lot of ways that LoopNet makes fees for listing properties. But you know what? At the end of the day, you're making a lot of people in the world aware of your property you have for sale, so maybe it's worth the money. But a lot of brokers don't want to bother with that if they already have a good following of people that know that they sell properties in Albuquerque or in Michigan or whatever. If a broker is already established, they might not bother with LoopNet simply because they feel like they've already got, well, I've already got, you know, 4,000 people on my email list. So when I list a property, I just send it out to my 4,000 people on my email list, and that's my buyer pool. Maybe that's the way they look at the world, right? Let's get back to that, getting on that. Let's get back to that email list in a second, because that is something we should talk about, right? Another reason why there's no good deals on LoopNet, okay, is let's talk about how brokers list properties. Let's go back to, like, let's say John the broker comes up with we'll draw a picture of John, a little stick figure of John, but we won't bother, right? Let's say John the realtor gets a 100-unit apartment building for sale, and he's in Topeka, Kansas. And John already has a good email list. So what he's going to do is he's probably going to go through the marketing process this way. He might go and take the listing as a pocket listing and off the market listing to his top three buyers that he knows are hungry. He knows they're going to pay a good price. He knows that they're his go-to people that he's very loyal to and everything like that. That's his top three. So the marketing process, let's just write this down, process for typically listing apartment building might look like he's going to take it to his top three. Okay? That might be what John does. What John also might do, and this is what happens when realtors really, really, when brokers really, really want to get the best price for a property, they'll go take it out and do a multiple bid and do a big bid process. And they'll take it and put it out without a price on it, and they'll do something called best and final. You guys have been on apartment buildings, you've heard of this, where the property goes to best and final round, where you gotta go and offer your price again, and you gotta keep increasing your number, and it's really intended to get the best price out of a property. And it's a lot of fun, it's very competitive. There's a lot, you have to go on interviews with the owner and stuff like that, and that's called the bid process. Okay, and that's typically what brokers do. They feel, a lot of brokers feel like that's part of their fiduciary responsibility to the owner to get them the best number they can, and they take it through this bid process. Sometimes the LoopNet will come into play here into the bid process. Okay, but if this broker has a already long list of people looking for a property in Topeka, Kansas, LoopNet might not even play in this because the broker knows that. Okay, I've got 2,000 people on my email list. I don't need LoopNet. I don't want to pay that fee to get my bid process full and to get the best number for my seller. Right? They may not need to do that. Now, if the seller has a number in their head and the broker puts the bid process done and it doesn't meet it, or if the broker realizes that the bid process isn't going to work for putting the property out for sale, then that might be where LoopNet comes in. Because a lot of brokers look at LoopNet as a last resort, right? As like, well, okay, because the reason why that is LoopNet is a large national net, okay? Anybody in the world can see properties for sale on LoopNet. It doesn't screen things, it doesn't let the broker filter and say, well, are you serious? Are you really a serious buyer? Have I seen your financials? Do I know that you can close? Do you have property management lined up in the area? So it's just such a wide net that gets cast in the market. That's another reason why brokers avoid it. So three reasons why brokers avoid LoopNet, or why there's not great deals on LoopNet all the time, is because they got to pay a fee. It's not a part of their process, which is take it to their top three and then take it out to a bidding process. Or LoopNet is a wide net. Okay, and brokers might not want to deal with a wide net of people, which is everybody and their mama coming out from the woodwork talking about how they want to buy properties and because they just went to a seminar and because they're super excited about multifamily, even though they don't have any of the relationships in place. The brokers would get inundated by phone calls if they put it on LoopNet if it's a really good deal. That's what they think. I've talked to them, that's what they said. Right? Now, sometimes they do have to put it on LoopNet. Sometimes they don't, it's a newer broker, they don't have the people on their list to do a full bidding process. Sometimes sellers request properties to go on LoopNet because they want absolutely everybody to know about this property, especially I find properties go on LoopNet sometimes when the broker's intention is to get the market-making number, like a number that's higher than anything's ever sold for, if they really want to push the market up a bit and they're willing to play this bid process game and they put it on LoopNet. Be careful of that. If you see a property on LoopNet that's still a bidding process war, understand that's the broker's intention to get crazy number for the property because they want everybody to be aware of it and then try and push you through the funnel to put it through best and final and everything like that. Okay? Now, the there are a few diamonds in the rough. This is the good deal that's on LoopNet, okay? The good deal. Okay, let's talk about a good deal, and I'll talk about how to leverage LoopNet when we close it out, okay? The good deal you might find on LoopNet is the deal with lots of hair on it. This is the problem child. This is the deal they can't put it through the bidding process because the seller doesn't want a bunch of people tramping through it. We bought a property in North Carolina that was in really, really rough shape. It was actually featured in the documentary Fair and Square on Bigger Pockets. So check that out. Check out Fair and Square on YouTube and you guys can hear the story of this property, which we bought on LoopNet, right? This property had a lot of problems when we bought it. Had, you know, active drug activity going on, and had low occupancy. It was in really, really rough condition. It was really, really dilapidated. It took a special buyer to buy that property. And the owner was also not the easiest to deal with, so he didn't want a bid process, which a bid process, by the way, something to remember, probably will look like, say, 20 to 30 people touring the property, lots of phone calls to the site doing their investigative work during their due diligence. It shines a big spotlight on the property for a period of time, and some sellers are not interested in having that go on. So what this person, the good deal that we found that had hair on it, what the broker did was they put it on LoopNet, and they waited on, and they waited on the right buyer to show up, and they screened a lot of the calls that came in, and they made sure the buyer that they made them do a phone interview with the broker, and made sure that the person really knew what they were looking at, made them aware of everything up front. And listen, just so you know, this property is not the cleanest, it's not the prettiest, but it's a good deal. But you got to be prepared to deal with this. So they did full disclosure of the hair that was on it on the phone, and they told us what was going on, and we were still interested, so we went down to look at it and we put it under contract. So the good deals that you see on LoopNet are the ones that you can, I've heard Brandon say this, that you don't find good deals, you make good deals. And so if you see a deal on LoopNet that you can turn around and make it a good deal by plucking a little bit of that hair off and making it more palatable, then that's a good deal. And a lot of times that's what you see on LoopNet, is stuff where the broker can't quite figure out what to do with it, and they can't do this, right? So they have to put it on LoopNet, right? That's a good deal you're gonna see, is a deal that's got a lot of issues. So it's either gonna be super overpriced thing that's gonna try and push you into this, into best and final, or it's gonna be a deal that has hair on it. And the reason for all this is, if a good deal does go on LoopNet, it doesn't have hair on it, think about that, right? If I've got a good deal and I'm gonna put it on LoopNet, it's a good price, doesn't have any hair on it, doesn't have anything going, doesn't have any problems, it's a pretty much get behind the wheel and drive and make good cash flow, and you can syndicate it if you want, it'll make good money for your investors, right? What's gonna happen to that deal on LoopNet? Gone. It's gonna go. And let's pretend that happens and a broker doesn't have a network, doesn't have his top three, doesn't wanna take it through a bidding process, decide, you know what, I don't have the time, let's go put it on LoopNet. That's gonna be gone in days. It's gonna go under contract, somebody's gonna swoop in and pick it up, right? So that is the third reason why you don't see good deals on LoopNet, is because they don't stick around for very long. Bottom line is, they're gonna get swooped up. If it's a really good deal, it's gonna get scooped up. And it's not because LoopNet doesn't have good deals, it's because LoopNet has a national reach. And so people that are on LoopNet looking for deals, if they see a good deal, they're gonna scoop it up. Or it's gonna be a deal with hair, or it's gonna try and push you into best and final, push you into this bidding process that where they're trying to push the price way up, okay? Now, let's talk about how you guys can use LoopNet efficiently, okay? You guys, if you're new to real estate, or if you've been doing real estate for a while, use LoopNet as I do, which I use LoopNet as a networking tool, okay? LoopNet does not have to be a deal finding tool only. Use it to find the good deal with hair on it, or the, let's call this the unicorn, right? The unicorn is the great deal that doesn't have any problems, okay? And that's possible, it exists, it's down here somewhere. They do show up sometimes on LoopNet. So surf LoopNet and look for the good deal with the hair on it that you can pluck the hair off and make it work. Take a mediocre deal and make it a great deal, that could be you. And you can also find the unicorn. But beyond that, use LoopNet most importantly. So it's like, you know, 20% of the time, 20% of the time, and then 60% of the time, this is like 5% of the time. This is more like, say, 35% of the time you're gonna find the deals with the hair on it. 5% of the time you're gonna find a unicorn. 60% of the time you're going to use it to network. And what does that mean, right? Using LoopNet to network, really what you wanna do is you wanna find this broker that's doing the best and final bid process, okay? That's doing this, and that's taking a property and putting it on LoopNet because the owner said, hey, I don't care who you have through here, give me the best price. Have 50 walkthroughs if you want. Give me the best price for this property. Broker says, okay, no problem, I'll do it. So put it on LoopNet. The next buyer, the next seller that comes to sell their property may not be looking for that many people walking through their property. They might not be looking for that much of a hassle for a sale. They might be looking for a nice clean transaction. And when they do that, that broker is maybe not gonna put it on LoopNet and do the shotgun approach. They're gonna just find a few people that they like and trust to do the deal. You wanna work your way here, okay? To be the top three that gets the first look on the deal before they put it out to best and final, before they do this awful bidding process thing, right? You want to get that phone call, number one. And the way you get there is by networking with the broker. You get to know them, call them every 2 to 3 weeks. If you've got the means, fly to the market and go meet them face to face. I'll tell you what, you will automatically get in there. If you just put yourself on an airplane and go down and meet with the top three brokers in a market that have sold things on LoopNet over the last couple of years, you'll likely get there. I'm not guaranteeing it, but you'll definitely get on the bidding list, and you might even work your way into the top three if you can prove to them that you're serious and you have the means to close, right? So visit them. Look at their deals. If they send you a deal, don't just take a glance at it and be cocky about it and say, ah, that's a bad deal. Underwrite it. Look at it. Run the numbers. Send your numbers to them. Hey, how did I do? I ran the numbers. What do you think? This is what I think of your deal, you know? I probably can't close it for the number that you're asking, but I could close it for this. What do you think? Then you show them you're serious, you're willing to engage, you're willing to look at their stuff, right? So underwrite their deals. Ask them about the market. Ask them for other introductions. Use these brokers you meet on LoopNet for other intros. Do you have a property manager? Do you have a mortgage broker? Do you have any of those people I can talk to? Ask those kinds of questions. But most importantly, what I found far and away made all the difference in the world is going out for a visit. So if you can swing it, go out for a 2-day visit to the market, sit down with everybody that's had properties for sale on LoopNet. They will take you 10 times more seriously if you do that. So sum it up, okay? This is what LoopNet is. Lots of asset classes. That's just apartment buildings, okay? And it's a commercial listing service, not a brokerage house. They're just there to put things on the market that people bring to them to put on the market. So it's not LoopNet's fault that there's no good deals there. It's just the market and the way that it is, okay? Remember, there's no good deals on LoopNet because it costs money to put them there. I hate to say that. And a lot of times it might not abide by the broker's process. They might want to just take it to their top three and send it out to bid and abide by the best and final bidding process that they want to use. And they might think that they've got an email list with enough people on it. Purpose of this is to get on that bid, is to get on that email list, right? Then you will see deals on LoopNet where the broker is just trying to pull the price up and pull you into a best and final bidding process to pull the price into the stratosphere. You will find good deals with lots of hair on them on LoopNet. That's about 35% of the times. Sometimes you're going to find a great deal that doesn't need anything, that's ready to roll. That's a unicorn. That's 5%. You can look for it. You'll see it. They do show up. 60% of the time you want to use LoopNet for networking, for opportunities to call brokers, go visit them, underwrite their deals, and see if they introduce you to other people. This is how you utilize the tool. And this is a lesson here in bottom line, guys, is there's always a way to make something like LoopNet benefit you. It's real easy to just scoff and say, nope, there's no good deals on LoopNet. That's easy. The hard thing to do is to look at LoopNet and find a way to leverage it for yourself to grow your business using something like LoopNet, even though it's competitive. Yes, even though, I'm sorry to say that. Yes, there are other people besides you that want to buy real estate right now. And so you'll need to use things like LoopNet to your benefit. Hopefully I gave you guys some value. If you guys have other thoughts on LoopNet or other things like CoStar or other listing services that are out there, leave it in the comment box. Let me know what you guys thought of today's lesson. Appreciate you guys watching. Have a good and profitable week.